So, in this question, 46th question, 46th question, there is a circuit and this resistance is R. The other resistance is 5 ohms and it is connected to a battery 10 volts. Power supply is given 10 volts. So what he is asking is, what is the value of R? He is asking the value of R. So how to find the value of R? And he also given us the power dissipated. The power is given, E, power dissipated in this circuit is in 30 watts power dissipated is given. Voltage is given, one resistance is given, other resistance is asking, power dissipated is given. So from these values, how to find this power dissipated? The question, the formula is V square by R equivalent of the circuit, total equivalent resistance of the circuit we have to take. So these two resistors are parallel to each other. R is parallel to 5 ohms. So when the resistors are parallel, what is their equivalent resistance? 5 into R by 5 plus R. This is the equivalent resistance. So now we already got V value, but now substitute the values in this equation to get the R value. What we get here, 30 is equal to power P is equal to 30. So 30 is equal to V square means 10 square by 5R by 5 plus R. 5R by 5 plus R. Okay, 5R by 5 plus R we got. Now 5R by 5 plus R means it gets reciprocated. Okay, so this will become how much it is, and what you'll get, 30 is equal to 100 by 5R into 5 plus R. Now you cross multiply this one to this side, what you'll get, 150R is equal to 500 plus 100R. Multiply this 100 with 5, as well as it should be multiplied with the R. Okay, so what do you get here? Now you take this 100R to this side, it becomes minus. So 150R minus 100R is equal to 500. So 50R is equal to 500. 50R is equal to 500. So what you'll get now here, at last R is equal to 500 by 50. So 0 cancel, 5 10 cancel. This implies R is equal to 10 ohms. This is our answer, 46th question. Okay, right. Next, next 47th question. So 47th question, in 47th question, what is given here? Also one circuit is given, right? So what is that circuit? Two resistors are parallel here, 9 ohm resistance and 6 ohms resistance. Two resistance are parallel and some battery is applied. What was this? We have one more resistor over here, that is 2 ohms. Here this is 9 ohms. This is 6 ohms. This is 2 ohms. Now first of all, the current I is flowing through this. It gets divided. It will be I1. It will be I2. Current flowing. And again it joins the two currents. I1 plus I2 join, it will form I1 plus I2 is equal to I. So what is the current flowing through 9 ohm resistor is asking, what is the current flowing through 9 ohms resistor? So here, so in the 9 ohms resistor, how much power is dissipated in the 9 ohms resistor? 36 watts. This much power is resistor, this much power is dissipated in 9 ohms resistor. And the potential difference across 2 ohms is asking. So what is the potential difference across 2 ohms? This value is asking. What is the potential difference across 2 ohms is asking. So we have to find the current. Total current we have to find. So total current means, first of all, we know this current. How to know this current? P is equal to V into I. Voltage into current. So but we know voltage is equal to V is equal to IR. IR into I, that is equal to I square R. So I want I square is equal to P by R. This R is cross multiplied here. Okay, the R is cross multiplied this side to this side. So P square, I square is equal to P by R. So I want I only. So I is equal to root P by R. So I want I1 now. I1 is equal to under root of P1. The power dissipated at I1 is P1, that is 36 by R is 9 ones are 9 fours. So this is equal to root 4, that is equal to 2 amps. So 2 amp current is I1. So current 2 amp is I1 means what will be I2? So I2 current how you will find is, if I2 current means, already we know that the potential difference across both resistors is the same. So how much we know that the potential difference across to both resistors is same. So we know that I1 R1 is equal to I2 R2. Okay, because both having the same potential difference as they are connected in parallel. Both resistors are connected in parallel, no? So they will have same potential difference. So we already know that this is R1, this is R1, and this is R2. This is R1, this is R2. So this is I1 and this is I2. So I1 R1 is equal to I2 R2. So from this, what we get now? I1 R1 is equal to I2 R2 means I1 is 9. Sorry, I1 how much we got? 2. 2. I1 we got 2 ohms. 2 amps. 2 amps we got I1. This is I1. I1 we got 2 amps. And R1 how much we have? 2 into 9. R1 is 9 ohms. Is equal to I2 we don't know. I2 into R2 we know. R2 is 6 ohms. So now cross multiplication. 2 into 9 by 6 is equal to I2. So 3 2s are 3 3s are 2 1s are 2 1s are cancel. So we get I2 is equal to 3 amps. I2 is equal to 3 amps we got. We got I1, we got I2. Now add this, you will get total current. I is equal to I1 plus I2, 2 plus 3, that is equal to 5 amps. Okay. So resistance is equal to 2 ohms. Now V across 2 ohms. Voltage, we are going to find voltage across 2 ohms. Voltage across 2 ohms. Voltage across 2 ohms resistor is I through 2 ohms resistor and resistance of 2 ohm, that is 2 ohms, it is 2. So we get V across 2 ohms resistor is equal to 5 into 2, that is equal to 10 volts. 10 volts. Okay. So how much voltage is there passing? What if here, how much voltage is there across 2 ohms resistance means 10 volts. We get 10 volts resistor is there. Like this. Okay. So in the question, 48th question, what is saying is there is a circle. This is formed by a wire of 12 ohms resistance. The total resistance of this wire is 12 ohms. 12 ohms is the resistance of this wire. Is bent into a form of complete circle of radius. The radius of the circle is 10 centimeters. The radius of the circle is 10 centimeters and this wire is having resistance 12 ohms. So now what he is asking, the resistance between two diametrically opposite points A and B is. So he is asking the resistance between two diametrically opposite points. Suppose here there is a B point, here there is a A point, diametrically opposite points. Okay, and this is 10 centimeters is the radius, and diametrically opposite means this is total 20 centimeters. Okay, we can take like this, we can take like this, no problem. Both are same. Diametrically opposite, you have to take that solve. Okay, right. Next, what he was finding is asking that the resistance between is asking. So we have to find the resistance between these two points. Okay, so effective resistance we have to find. So like that. Okay, now. So here diametrical means it is exactly half. This is, he divided these two resistors into R by 2 is divided, right? Okay, length is half, no? Diametrical opposite means R by 2, this is. Okay, right? So here given that radius is equal to 10 centimeters. So you have to convert this into meters. So 10 by 100 meters, that is equal to 0.1 meter. This is the radius. You know the radius means what is will be the circumference. Circumference means nothing but length of the wire, total wire length of the wire. Total length of the wire is total length of the wire is 2 pi r. So 2 pi r, that is equal to 2 pi into 0.1. So that is equal to how much? 2 pi into 0.1 means it is 0.2 pi. This is the total length of the wire. So resistivity is given. Resistivity is for 1 meter it is 12 ohms. This is for 1 meter it is 12 ohms. So 0.2 meters how many ohms you will have? So total resistance of the wire is equal to RL. Resistance of the wire of length L is equal to 0.2 pi into 12. That is equal to 2.4 pi. ohms. This is the total resistance of the wire. Now we want R by 2, half resistance we want. So R by 2 means what we get here? R by 2, that is half resistance we want. So RL by 2, that is RL by 2 must be equal to 20.2.4 pi by 2, that is equal to how much? That is equal to 1.25 ohms. So R by 2, these are in parallel. So what is the effective resistance then? So effective resistance is equal to 1 by RL by 2 plus 1 by, that is 1 by R effective is equal to 1 by RL by 2 by 1 by RL by 2. So simply we want to find effective resistance means RL by 2 into RL by 2 by 2 into RL by 2. So RL by 2 plus RL by 2, so we will get to RL by 2, okay. R1 R2 by R1 plus R2, both are same. So what we will get, RL by 2 means 1.2 pi into 1.2 pi by 2.4 pi. So what we will get here, this is 1 ja, this is 2 ja, 2 1 ja, 2 0.6 ja. So you will get 0.6 pi. R effective is equal to 0.65 ohms. This is the resistance between A and B points. Okay, this is the resistance between A and B points. Like this, we can find out. So, 49th question, what he is saying means here, in the circuit shown, the current through the 4 ohms resistor is 1 amp. When the points P, M are connected to a DC voltage source, the potential difference between the points M and N. So between M and N, what are the potential difference? Means nothing but he is asking the potential difference between across 1 ohm resistance is asking. So you see the circuit. What is the circuit means? This is 4 ohms. This is 4 ohms. It is connected parallel to 3 ohms. It is connected parallel to 3 ohms. And next, this is 0.5 ohms. And to this parallel again, one more 0.5 ohms is connected. 0.5 ohms is connected. Okay. And it is connected to 1 ohms. This is N point and this is connected to 1 ohm, and these two are connected now. Now this is M point and this is N point. So this is P point and this is N point as usual, okay. So what is asking here? What is asking? He is asking the voltage across this point is asking. Voltage across this is equal to how much? So first of all, we have to find the current. How much current is flowing, we have to find first of all. So initially the current will be, here I current will be flowing, but it is getting divided. Okay. And this one will be divided again here. This is I1, this is I2. Current gets divided here. Okay. So what he said? In the circuit shown, the current through the 4 ohms resistor is, this is 4 ohms resistor, the current through the 4 ohm resistor is 1 amp, he said. 1 amp current is flowing. So I1 is equal to 1 amp is given. And so whenever 1 amp voltage is given here, same voltage is across 3 and 4, voltage is the same, So voltage is the same, means I1 into R1 is equal to I2 into R2, we said, right? From this we can find out I2 value. So how to find I2 value? I1 is 1, 1 into R1 is 4, is equal to I2 into 3. So I2 is equal to 4 by 3. So I is equal to, here I is equal to I1 plus I2. So I1 plus I2 means that is equal to 1 plus I2 is 4 by 3. So take LCM, we get 3, 1 ja 3, 3 plus 4, 7. 7 by 3 is the current. So current we got, current into resistance, again voltage. Voltage is equal to IR. So IR means here this is R. R is equal to 1 ohm. So what we get, V is equal to 7 by 3 into 1. That is equal to 7 by 3 volts. This is the voltage across 1 ohm. So if you cancel this, what you will get? 3 1 ja 3 2 ja 6. 3 2 ja 6. Six means 2.3 you're getting, no? So like this. So here what is the PD across these two things is IR. IR means 4 into 1, 4 volts. Here PD across these points is, that is between P and M, is 4 volts. 4 volts PD is there. Okay. So MNP, current in MNP. So current flowing is how much? It is correct, or no? Okay, that option only given wrong. 2.3 is the right answer. 3.2 does not exist. Okay, you won't get 3.2. Okay, 2.3 only we will get. So like this we have to find, right? Next question. Now 50th question. 50th question. So what is asked, is given that one circuit is given. This is 2 ohms. This is connected in parallel with 4 ohms. And again this is connected in parallel with 1 ohm. This is with 5 ohms. So like this we have a circuit. And this is connected to a battery. This is connected to a battery. Like this. So now what is asking, he is saying that the current flowing through I1, that is I1 is equal to 3 amps through resistor 2 ohms, and this is 4 ohms resistor. This current is I2. Current flowing through these resistors is I3, that is 1 ohm and 5 ohms. Now what is the power dissipated in 5 ohms? In 5 ohms what is the power dissipated, he is asking. Power dissipated in 5 ohms. power dissipated in 5 ohms is asking. So already we know that power is equal to, the formula is I square R is a formula. In 5 ohms resistor, what will be the formula? Suppose this one is R1, this one is R2, this one is R3, this one is R4. Current flowing through is I3. So I3 square R4 we have to find. So what is the current flowing through this one we have to find. Before finding that, we know that when they are connected in parallels, the potential difference across the terminal common points will be same. So I1 R1 is equal to I2 R2 is equal to I3 into R3 plus R4. Okay. So I1 R1 means 3 into 2 is equal to I2, we don't know, I2 into 4 is equal to I3 into 6. So if you equate these two things, we will get I3. So I3 is equal to, I3 into 6 is equal to 6. So I3 is equal to 6 by 6, that is 1 amp. So how much current is flowing through this 5 ohms resistor means 1 amp current is flowing. So 1 amp current is flowing. Substituting this, we get power dissipated by 5 ohms resistor is equal to 1 square into 5, that is equal to 5 watts is our answer. Okay. Thank you.